The power and the grace, the elegance and the excitement, the adventure and the allure. This is sailing, a place to find yourself and a place to set yourself free. If you haven't experienced the thrills of sailing and the joy of being in open waters, stay with us as we lead you into a world of wonder and beauty. And if you are an avid sailor, we've got a whole new outlook on your sport, from navigation and naval architecture to the boat of your dreams. Hello and welcome. I'm Gary Jobson, and I'll be bringing you all these things on a series of shows tailored for those of us who love sailing and those of us just curious enough to learn about this incredible sport. But first things first. The first man to sail strictly for pleasure was King Charles II of England. It happened in 1646. After his partial exile to the Isle of Jersey, the king took to sailing a small boat to pass the time, and getting quite good at it, the king decided he needed a larger boat, a yacht. So being the king, which is good, he had one built in the boat-building capital of the world, Rotterdam. The Mary was built as a 52-foot sloop. It was a boat built for a king, complete with a complement of 10 cannons, just in case. By the way, Charles II is also famous for participating in the first known yacht race. It was in 1661 and featured Charles versus the Duke of York, Greenwich to Gravesend and back. You guess who won? As I said, it's good to be the king. By the 18th century, sailing had really grown. In 1720, the Water Club was formed in Cork, Ireland. Now, this was the first yacht club in the world. And in 1844, the New York Yacht Club was formed, which still stands today as a bastion of international sailing. But let's jump ahead and start our look at modern sailing. What happens when a first-time sailor decides he or she wants to get into the sport? The first thing a novice might want to do is take a course at one of hundreds of sailing schools around the country. And the Coast Guard Auxiliary offers many classes that can be found on the internet with times and places. The key to sailing efficiently is to have the proper sail trim for your angle to the wind. Right now we're on a close reach with the apparent wind at 60 degrees off the bow. Now my goal is to get the sail to luff or flutter evenly at the top and the bottom of the sail. If it flutters at the top before the bottom, then I need to move the jib lead forward. If it flutters at the bottom first, then I move the jib lead aft. When your sail is trimmed properly, let me get it in right, there it is. When your sail's trimmed properly, you've got maximum speed and your boat is sailing efficiently. For those of you who sail quite often, here's another tip: reading the wind. Now the problem is you can't see it, so you have to see what the wind does on other objects. Take a look at the water. Dark patches indicate more wind because the ripples are closer together, and I can tell the intensity of the wind and also what direction it's coming from the different angles. I also can read the wind by looking at my masthead fly. Non-sailors might call it a weather vane. It moves back and forth. You can tell what the wind is doing on your sails, flags, smokestacks, other boats, and even birds. Birds always take off directly into the wind. Now that you're hooked and feel pretty good about sailing, you want to spend some time on the water. But what about the boat? Well, you could buy a boat and ask yourself, should be a wood boat or fiberglass, a skiff or a catamaran? There's lots of choices and some answers. The fundamental question to ask is, how are you going to use this boat? Is it cruising, racing, day sailing? Is it a boat for two people or too many people? The biggest question to ask is, what can I really afford? If you're just starting out, remember, all the owners I know never keep the same boat their entire lives. Moving up is part of the fun. If you think about it, there might be a very interesting way to get into sailing that could be right for you. It's a program where you can lease a boat. It's a way to get into sailing and not have to spend a lot of money doing it. And there are many fine companies out there to do boat leasing. Before we let you go, there's one thing more that we want to share with you, and that is how exciting, comfortable, and a sailboat can be. Let's talk about naval architecture. Now, I don't mean putting 10 cannons on your sunfish, but how do you design a boat that goes modest speed, that's safe, and allows you to enjoy your precious time out there on the water. As we take you more deeply into this series, we will explore all the options that are open to the sailor. Cruising, racing, equipment, the latest technology, navigation, whatever there is, Sailor's Log will bring it to you in a thorough and well-explained way, done in a beautiful and relaxing setting with tips and ideas all sailors can use. There's a lot more that all of us can learn in sailing, but remember this, the most important thing is having a good time. For all of us at Sailor's Log, I'm Gary Jobson. Thanks for being with us.